Hi everyone, the new SharePoint Brand Center is out. The centralized branding management application that will empower your brand managers or designer users to empower site owners to create and manage the brand assets needed to customize SharePoint and Viva connections. You can now easily add custom fonts to SharePoint and make them available through the Brand Center tenant-wide, so you can put your stamp on your intranet. Let's go. Here I am in admin.microsoft.com. I am connected as global admin in this tenant. First of all, in order to enable Brand Center, we have to click on settings and then let's go on org settings. Here you will find a new item called Brand Center Preview. Let's click on this one. As you can see, I have here now the suggestion to create a new Brand Center. The name by default is this one, Brand Guide. And this is the URL of my new Brand Center. In order to go forward, it's important that you check this option. I agree to activate the public CDN. Otherwise, your files stored there will be not available across the entire organization. So this is very specific and important to do. If we want to make our custom fonts available cross-tenant, we have to check this one. All right, now let's go with create site. All right, my site is now created. I have this URL, Sites Brand Guide, and down below you can see a new page that has been deployed and provided in this site. We will go in a minute. Let me now switch on another tenant that I have here, and let me reopen the same page, Settings and then Org Settings. Here again, Brand Center. And here, as you can see, we have a different experience because on this tenant in the past, I created an org site assets. If you don't know what I'm referring it, you can check in the link of the description or in the link in the upper right corner. In that video, I'll show you how you can create an org site assets in your organization that will store basically images and documents as office templates. Now that I want to create a Brand Center here, SharePoint is getting the existing one that I already created in the past and will add a page. I can click now on activate the CDN. It's already there because I already configured this to be public CDN. And then I will have, moreover, this page added to my site, brandcenter.aspx, and this is the page that will allow you to upload and create your custom fonts. Now, I'll show you the site assets, basically how it works. So I am here on this SharePoint page. If I edit this page, that's the reason why I created a site assets in the past. When I click on edit this webpart and then on change, I'm able then to have this option, your organization, and I have documents, and here I have my org images. So these are stored in my site assets, in my Brand Center, and in the documents we have all images that we have seen before. So basically this is the reason why in the past I created a site assets. And you can use it also to store your office templates. Here I have a bunch of PowerPoint and one as a Word template. Now let me go on office.com. Let's say that I want to create a new PowerPoint. Let's click on PowerPoint, and now I have this folder here, Office Templates. When I click on it, and then here under my organization, I have all my templates that I uploaded in the library that we have seen in the Site Assets alias Brand Center. All right. It's time now to explore this functionality and how I can create fonts on this Brand Center. All right, I switched now on my MVP tenant with the Brand Guide just created, the Brand Center just created. Now, when I click on this link, I can read more information about the SharePoint Brand Center. So, very down below, you can see the section that we want to explore, which is Brand Fonts. When I click on this link now, I can see supported files that I can upload. There is this table, and here I can see all supported font files types. So, the ones supported are TTF, OTF, WAF, and WAF2. For my demo, I have a WAF2. All right, so let's go back on my settings admin, and now let's open this site. So let me copy this one and let me paste the link in the search URL. Okay, now I am opening this new brand center that I just created. So this is a normal communication site, nothing special here. So when I click on site contents, I can see the classic document library. So in order to create now the font that I want, you can go on the wheel icon and then there is the brand center preview. So clicking on that one, I have now this page open that we have seen before, brandcenter.aspix. Let me take again this one. It is exactly this app, which is a normal aspix page. All right, now what I can do here. So first of all, I need to upload my font, okay? So let's click on the plus button and let's start to add some file that I already have here open in my file explorer. I have this one, Font Awesome, downloaded for free from the Font Awesome site. And okay, now my file is uploaded. It is a WAF2, so I can go back now. And now I can see that my font is uploaded. What to do next? I need to create a package for my custom font. And this then will be available across SharePoint and Viva Connections. Very important. So let's click now on SharePoint and let's add this font package. Let's click on the plus button. And now if I click on this drop-down, I can see the custom font just uploaded. Font Awesome. You can decide if in your package you want to combine several custom fonts or use just one. In my case, I want to use Font Awesome in every case to cover every scenario. Okay, so let's click now on next. And here we can see that we can assign a specific font for title, headline, body, interactive. It's really up to you how you want to create your font package. So as I said, I want to use the custom font just uploaded for every use case. So I'm going to use this one for every option that we have here. All right, now it's done. I can go on next. Now I have to decide a name from my font and it will be just Font Awesome. Okay. It will be visible across every site in my organization in the change the look option. All right, let's click on save. Now it's saved. But before to save, if you want, you can clicking on the tab SharePoint or Viva Connections, you can have a preview. So this is my custom font, how it looks like, apply it to the homepage of my SharePoint site. This is a communication site. If I click on the Viva Connections, I can see now this font applied to the Viva Connections dashboard. All right, that's it. This is all you need to do to create your custom font. Now that is ready to go, it's time to apply this one to a site that I have on this tenant. Okay, this is the home site of my SharePoint environment, so I can apply easily this one to my site. Okay, let's start to do that. So let's click on the wheel icon and then change the look. Here there is a new option, font in preview, and now we can see that the Microsoft standard applied is Segoia UI, but you can change this with other fonts provided by Microsoft. So as you can see, it's already changed at runtime. In real time, on the fly, is changing the font. Now let's select the one that I created. And now again, the font change accordingly. It's applied everywhere. So I can click on save. And this, of course, will be applied to my SharePoint site and to Viva Connections as well. I can open the dashboard of Viva Connections and we can see the new font up and running here, applied on the command bar, here in the menu, here in the in every card of my Viva Connections dashboard. And that's it. So you can open, of course, a specific page if you want. Let's take one page that I created in the past. Let's go on this one, for example, new store. Oh, here there's nothing. Let me select one that contains some data inside. So, but this is the font applied here in the same way in the body. So it's pretty cool. Very, very cool. Now, let me show you in the last step how custom font can be easily applied in a SharePoint framework. Let's say that you have a web part that you want to upload and you want to make it available across your organization, and then you can use the same custom font there as well. Here I am in Visual Studio Code. I created a new SharePoint framework solution. This is a normal web part. I'm going now to copy this query string because I'm running this solution locally, and I want to use this query string to open my web part in one of my SharePoint page that I have here. I'm going to copy this query string, I'm going to reopen this page, and now I have this pop-up. I need to load and debug my scripts, so I'm going to hit this button, and then I'm going to edit now this page so I can upload my web part. My web part is called SPFX. SPFX custom fonts. Let me load this web part. Okay, now this web part is added in the page. I'm going to republish my page. And now what I'm going to do is clicking on the wheel icon, change the look. Let's hit the button on font. And now I'm going to change the font to Font Awesome. As you can see, my web part is not reacting. So let me save this font, Font Awesome. Let's click on the button Save. And now the new font is applied, as you can see from at the bottom with the title, the menu, even this title on the page is changed, but the text of my web part looks the same. Now, what I can do to make my web part adapting to the change of fonts in SharePoint? So it's very easy and straightforward. So what I do is adding this property in the CSS in the styles of my web part. So let me copy now this one, because this is a new class added with this new capability in SharePoint, and currently this web part is not implementing this new property. Probably in the future this will be included out of the box, so it means that when I create a new web part, this will be automatically support this new capability. What to do next is going on the CSS of this web part, and now what I can do here is adding this property in the classes that are used in the web part. So I will do this in the first one, and I will do the same in the welcome text and even in the link, because we have also the link. All right, so now it's added everywhere. I will run again my web part and let's see if now works. Okay, now my web part is running again. Let me reopen the page, and now theoretically I can refresh this page, and voila, now the new font is applied to the web part as well. Now let me show you this in real time by going on change the look again, font preview, and let me change the font so we can see that the text is really changing in the web part. As you can see, pretty cool, right? So let me select Georgia, and now Georgia is applied. So let me go back again on Fontasm and let me save. So voila, this is all right. I hope you enjoyed this video. If yes, please consider to subscribe, like, and add a comment down below. Let me know what do you think about the SharePoint Brand Center. I hope to see you next time. Bye.